Well, I did it. I finally broke the logic of the game. Have you ever imagined yourself having to grind slow on purpose to make more money? Because that's basically Fogans in a nutshell. Today's area is extremely easy to grind, extremely profitable, and so brain dead that you will almost guaranteed fall asleep halfway through because you have to slow yourself down in order to burn as little agris as possible and to let your pets loot everything from the ground. It's just that boring. So sit back, relax, and let's begin the discussion. As always, I'm gonna mention again this area is very much like Centaurs. I used a blue loot scroll and the agris buff enabled for the entire hour for all of my hours because this area is very agris efficient. If you remember the agris efficiency chart I made about a week ago on all of the reworked Valencia areas, back then I concluded that Centaurs was the most efficient place to burn your agris points and Fogans wasn't really that far behind. But I want you to look at this number with 76%. Essentially, when I tested all of these areas, I was going at my normal as fast as possible grinding speed and Fogans was only at around 76%. My pets only got to loot 76% of the trash on the ground and 24% of it was wasted. It was agris points I never made any use of. So because of that, I said when I revisit this area, so for today in particular, I'm gonna purposely grind slow and see if I can increase that efficiency and use less points. And that brings me to this new entry here at the top of the chart. 95% is what I was able to manage my pet efficiency, and that basically places this area at the top of the chart as the most efficient area in Valencia to burn agris points, at least for now. So that kind of raised an interesting question. What if I take the exact same spreadsheet and simulate 100% loot for all of the Valencia areas? Assuming you somehow let your pets loot absolutely everything, which area is truly the most agris efficient? In which case, it's basically Bashims or Fogans, more or less the same at this point. It only matters where I can get more trash per hour. And someone commented, why don't I put money per 20,000 agris made, in which case it's this new column, and it's basically the same. There's no difference, it's just a different way of showing agris efficiency. But still, I'm kind of going off topic. I just wanted to say, for Fogans for today, we use agris points. It's really good, I recommend it a lot, and I did basically make as much money as Centaurs, long story short. So yeah, let's talk about some actual money per hour numbers. Normally at this point I would say, let's take a look at how this area used to be before the buff, before today, but in this case there's no prior test of me on Fogans, at least not in the past, let's say, 3 years. So let's just say for the sake of reference, this area was worth less than 100 million silver before it was reworked. And that brings us to today. Today I play both Guardian and Corsair. Once again I used both of them for this area in particular. I grinded 6 hours in total. I basically one-shot the monsters. My gear is completely irrelevant. You can grind this place on season gear, so it literally doesn't matter. The only thing that kind of matters is your pets. I do have full tier 4 pets, and as I said, that's kind of the main reason why I have to slow down and purposely grind slower, because even with full tier 4 pets, I'm hardly able to loot everything from the ground. So that's a big, you know, problem. In terms of how my experience went with the 6 hours, I used the cave rotation for every single hour because it's the most dense place in the area that I know of. I can't really recommend other rotations, but the cave one in particular is really good. It was really empty. I hardly saw one or two people just walking around, but for the most part I was left alone, so no issues whatsoever, at least for now until the video comes out. I saw a couple of Afuaru spawn every now and then, but it was very much like Centaurs. Just like the money per hour and the agris efficiency, the Afuarus are kind of the same. You might get one or two of them per hour, but nothing groundbreaking. And yeah, I grinded 4 hours before this week's patch, before we got the Rokaba chests and the blackstone pouches. So we have 4 hours before, and then I did 2 more hours after to see exactly what changed. So yeah, let's take a look at the results. At the end, you know, I stored all of my items in a bank, yada yada, and we reach today's conclusion, which is this spreadsheet. Once again, 4 hours before the patch, where I had a bunch of Rokaba, in this case shoes and the scrolls, stored in the marketplace, and hardly any blackstones whatsoever, if you can even spot them. I got 39 from extracting 4 enhanced Rokaba shoes, and that's literally where most of them came from. And I forgot to say the black energy residue, I had like 500 of it. This one was removed from the patch, so I didn't value it whatsoever in the spreadsheet. And after the patch, the 2 hours, nothing else changed. The Kiafra drop rate is still very poop, but now you get chests for Rokabas, which you can open, and you actually get all 4 types of Rokabas. I wouldn't call that an actual buff, but it's a change at least. And yeah, the Blackstone pouches. Look at this, 200 Blackstones in 2 hours, like 100 of them per hour. So that is definitely a minor buff to Fogans. For the trash per hour, it's this breakdown over here with the 6 hours. Hour 4 was the only one I did on Corsair. Hours 5 and 6 after the patch, it was basically on average 14,700, which is, funny enough, exactly what I got when I did the 1 hour test, when I was going as fast as possible with that 76% trash loot efficiency. So going slower this time, I'm able to get the same amount of trash per hour, but in this case my pets loot around 95 or 96% of what is on the ground, and I burn less Agris points. I was very pleased with this outcome. Kiafras are very scarce, like you might get 5 of them, I think it's per hour, no, 7. 7 Kiafras per hour average, and for everything else, you can just, you know, quantity, price, drop, items dropped per hour. In terms of distribution, like 70% comes from trash alone, your profit, and around 30% from items you sell to the marketplace, and 300 million silver average per hour on blue plus agris, or around 230 if you use yellow loot scrolls, which I would not recommend. So what is the conclusion for today? In particular, this area is literally a copy paste of centaurs, but instead of getting black magic crystals, you get other items. So if you want black magic crystals, go to centaurs. If you don't care about the black magic crystals and you just simply want the profit, Fogans is literally identical in terms of agris usage, in terms of the money per hour, and in terms of the monsters being one-shottable. My honest recommendation is, if you actually are around season gear and you have to grind Valencia in particular, just burn your Agris points at either Fogans or Centaurs, and when you eventually run out of Agris, that's when you can consider Sulfur Mines or Pilaku Jail to grind on yellow loot scrolls, because it's kind of hard to beat a blue loot scroll versus a yellow loot scroll. I would much rather burn Agris and a blue loot scroll instead of having to use yellow loot scrolls at Sulfur Mines to make hardly more money than this. Maybe Sulfur is 350 million silver per hour. With that being said, this time for sure, I will see you next time with a bunch of Elvia areas. Thank you very much for watching if you made it this far, I appreciate it a lot. Consider becoming a member, a channel member, if you wanna support the channel. Like the video if you enjoyed it, leave a comment, you know, all of the standard stuff. And catch you next time. Have a good rest of your evening. Bye bye.